And I can't take it back, so in the past is where we'll leave it. So there you go, oh. Can't make a wife out of a hoe, oh.
Y'all ain't ready for this sponsor. I got some gluten-free vegan candies from Masaki Tokyo, and I'm about to try them in front of you. First of all, look at how cool the box is it comes in. Like, those are the candies. There will be a part two to this. I'm gonna try this one first. I'm kind of scared. Different. But I like it. This one looks like a really cool crystal. Like, I'm kind of excited to try this one too. Oh, that's like a really good lemony flavor. Like, I like that one. This one looks like a cool rock. I just broke it. We will bite that part. That's different. This one looks really cool. Like, I feel like I'm eating a dragon's tear. That one's good too. That one tastes like green tea. Part two's coming up. Part two of trying the candies. Ooh. So there were three of these in the little package I just opened. Let us try. That one's different. It's different. The texture isn't my favorite, but the taste is good. This one looks like it's about to hurt my teeth, but it's also pretty. I like this one. It's good. This kind of looks like a mango flavor, like what a mango would taste like. Oh, it's strawberries. This is definitely my favorite by far. That one actually tasted like a strawberry mango smoothie. This one also came in like 5 different pieces. So let's do it. Oh, that one's good. It kind of tasted like a little cake you get out of an easy bake oven. Get these candies and use my discount code in the caption below.
Politika masala. Masala.
So I have some daily advice. I always get told that I'm sensitive and kind, and I want to express on how I am. I look at everyone equally. My family, my friends, my boyfriend, people I don't like or hate. There's never a reason for me to be mean. I get hate comments all the time for being too skinny or just people not liking how I look. But there's never a reason for me to be mean back. Everyone has something about them that's beautiful, and it's their feelings. I always try to put myself in somebody else's shoes. Think about what they're going through. I know that every time that I'm upset, or when I'm sad, or mad, or angry, I want people to understand. I want people to listen. And that's one way to be kind. Listening to others, trying to put yourself in that situation, instead of fighting back. You can also be kind in many different ways, just like this Christmas. Instead of wanting a bunch of presents, why not give back? Give to those who have really listened, who have been kind to you, who have helped you through hard times. It'll make you feel great, and them as well. Make them feel appreciated. Write them a letter, give them a hug, and that's how to be kind.
Destination unknown as we're pulling for some gas. Officially pasted poster reveals a smile from the back. Elephants and acrobats, lion, snakes, monkey. Village speaks righteous, Sister Cena says funky. How bizarre. How bizarre. How bizarre.
Tell me that you're not mentally stable without saying, I'm not mentally stable.
So in the morning, I usually wake up before my alarm. Maybe like 5 minutes before my alarm. Every morning, I text my boyfriend. I'm like, hey, good morning. Like, hey. And there are multiple nights that I do this. I get up trusting myself that it's 5 minutes before my alarm goes off. I go shower, brush my teeth, brush my hair, do my makeup, make sure my fit is popping. And I get a text from my boyfriend right in the middle of it. Why are you awake? Because it's time for me to get up. You know it's like 1 in the morning there, right? So you're telling me, you are telling me that I woke up 5 hours before my alarm, got ready, and I didn't care once to look at the time on my phone? I hope that's good enough.
Sing along if you know this song from the 2000s.
Don't you wish your girlfriend was
with your boom boom.
You kill me, mom.
Now I ain't saying she a gold digger, but she ain't messing with no broke.
Well, back door, baby, bye bye bye.
Bye bye. I don't wanna be a fool for you.
All the time I turn around, brothers gather around, always looking at me up and down, looking at my. I just wanna.
Oh my god, did he call her baby? Maybe I'm not okay. Play it cool, cause he likes that cool.
I don't know why this is happening either. I have gotten so many comments about this. And it's just that one video too. If you have seen that video on your For You page, comment that you've seen that on your For You page. But if you've seen it more than once, I don't know what TikTok's trying to do. I think it might be broken. Actually, it's been broken for a while. But like, I'm sorry if you get annoyed from seeing that one video. I'm sorry that my face is just annoying in general. But like, I'm sorry that that video keeps popping up. I'm so sorry to so many people. But I hope you have a great day. And I hope that video doesn't pop up on your For You page again.
Okay, lesson number one. This is how you do the head thing. Yeah, that's right. I went there.
Honesty and responsibility. Oh, no, but seriously, who should we blame? Like an innocent bystander or something? How about that lady? She looks pretty defenseless. Hey, lady, why'd you do that to our car?
It was a day to remember. Although I hope you forget the part about me attacking Santa Claus and then going to jail.
Thank you for introducing me. But I do have an actual name. It's Maddie.
Why does it have to be dodgeball? Why can't it be a nice, friendly game of Jack?
Cody, come on! We have to get ready for the next fabulous episode of the web show that's sweeping the nation! Yay me! Starring London Tipton!
I'm gonna try that one trend.
Hi. Hey.
I didn't know that was possible! Shut up! I have superpowers.
Hey.
Bruh, how?
I'm an echo. So there's a movie on Netflix called If Anything Happens, I Love You. It's 12 minutes long. It's supposed to be really sad. And this is my face before watching it. So stay tuned.
I didn't even finish it. I'm still watching. That shit.
Yes way, I'm gonna show you. You're gonna go to princessmovies.org. It'll show up with a page like this, and you press Barbie movies. It'll show all of this stuff, and then it'll show the movies, right? Look at all those beautiful Barbie movies. I want to watch The Nutcracker because it's after Thanksgiving, and now it's time to start off with the Christmas. It will show this. Do not press any of this, okay? Do not press that. You're gonna scroll down even more, and look! There's the heckin' movie! Look at it! And it's gonna play! Not only does it have Barbie movies, it has princess movies, Monster High movies, live action movies, and Disney movies. So, I don't know if Netflix and Disney Plus can compete this time. These are some childhood memories right here. But it works. Trust me. Guys, stop it. So I don't know about y'all, but I was obsessed with the Barbie movies when I was little, okay? And I don't know who thought of this first on TikTok, but please add them in the comments. If y'all are big Barbie fans like me, this freaking website saved my life. So you wanna go to this website and you wanna click on Barbie movies, right? Barbie, right? It's gonna show the whole list of Barbie movies, okay? You just press on that one. And it's gonna take you to like, it'll say like, play now. Don't press that. Don't press like the picture of Barbie with her freaking cover on there. Don't press that. It'll just go to ads and stuff. Just scroll all the way down and you'll see a black screen. And that's the movie. That's what you play. Every few minutes, it like goes back like 5 seconds in the movie. But it's the full movie. Like my childhood is being reborn. I just watched Rapunzel. I just watched Princess and the Pauper. I sang all the songs. Y'all need to do this. It'll save your life. Trust me when I say it's worth it.
From the top, let's go.
No.
Potter.
Oh.
Guys, we have to have another chat.
Please explain to me why there is still TikTok drama and why all of you guys are getting into it. I understand that they're being mean to each other, and TikTokers are mean to each other, but I don't understand why everybody just can't stay out of it. It doesn't need to be other people's business. And what I mean by that is the hate comments on the videos. You guys go at these specific influencers, these specific very well-known people, who are doing little things that most of you guys do every day. You guys give criticism, you guys give hate, but it really upsets me that there's literally people on TikTok who think just because I have a small account, I can post as many hate comments as I want and nobody will care. Seriously? You guys cannot turn cyberbullying into a trend. No matter how famous the person is. As the old saying goes, if you don't have something nice to say, don't say it at all. I literally expected more from this generation. We have all this new technology, and yet we're teaching our kids to cyberbully. Not today, kiddos. Go spread some positivity and just be nice.
So, I've realized, like, this Charlie and Trisha and James stuff has been going around, and I think it's very problematic. And this is a post for you to get away from that. We don't need to be in other people's drama, and we don't need to choose sides like sixth graders. TikTok is supposed to be fun. TikTok is supposed to be about supporting others and lifting each other up. So, my little kiddos, I hope you're having a wonderful day today. And if you aren't, I hope it gets a lot better. You know what? This is for you. Have a cupcake. I missed TikTok when it was Musical.ly. Now it's all just criticism. Seeing who can do dances better, seeing who can act better. It's all a competition. Why can't it be just everyone having fun? There's haters and stuff, but I feel like these bigger creators should be spreading positivity about each other instead of fighting. That's my view on it. I know it's just giving hate to other pages, sending people over to their page. Spread positivity instead. Everyone deserves to be heard, but in a positive way.